What do you need? Okay. What do I need? You know, I'm 29 now. I've seen a few things. I know a few things. I know that people need love. They need money in their pocket to be able to do the daily, the day type things, you know. They need comfort. They need peace. They need support. This is what we need. It's not about want. Wanting is more of you need it for comfort, to help with whatever, your day-to-day, whatever. You want that because it's a luxury, because you don't have to put in the work. You know, the more we advance, I see that the less work people want to put in, including relationships. Some family members I got, you know, we've had FaceTime, that's it, you know what I mean? Just, there's no get-togethers, there's no holidays, there's no, nothing like it used to be. So we need the worst part of everything about going through things is having flashbacks of everything that broke you. You know, I wish there was somebody to apologize for everything that no one's ever said sorry for. You know, wish it was like that. You know, the older I get, the more that I look at the world in a different light. And I won't say world, just where I'm at, you know. Me, I'm always in the spotlight. I'm always, you know, I'm always being me. But what happens when all that stops? What happens when it's just me in my bed with my thoughts? Just me in the bed just thinking. I think that's probably the most alone feeling I guess you can have. Just because, like I say, people, including myself, put less effort into relationships. And it's something I need to work on as a person, reaching out to everybody who I grew up with, you know, and maybe getting together once or twice or scheduling something, you know, a traditional thing. You know, nowadays, I use the excuse, I'm way too busy for everything. Well, sometimes I am, don't get me wrong, this shit, you know, like, it's got a price that comes with it, the hours ago and everything, I mean. But what does it cost? You know, that's the real question. Everything has a price, but what is this costing me? this album I'm doing for Happy, for my little brother, for Chris. It's probably the most I've tapped into myself, like, ever. And in doing so, it awoken a lot of things. It awoke a lot of memories, a lot of traumas I've been through. Shit that you wouldn't believe happened, or things that just don't seem real, you know. And they are. They're very real. And as I sit here and I write and I reflect and I go through the motions of recording and trying to bring that story to life, putting as much emotion I can in it, it takes a toll on you as a person. Because you have to relive each and every word. What do I need? What do I want? Me as a man, I'm sitting here today on my front porch figuring it out. And I don't think it's gonna come in a day. I think this is gonna be something I really have to take a step back and see the big picture. You know, everybody wants that house with the white picket fence, you know. They want that. That's what most people in life, they chase that. What happens when you've been working so hard at this one goal and it comes to fruition? Then what? What are you going to chase then? A lot of people's forgotten about what a dream is. You know, what is? What did you want to be when you were younger? Me, I've been living my dream for a long time. I've been doing music. I've been recording with great artists. Been engineering. I've been learning. I've been doing videos. I've been incorporating myself into different fingers of the glove. I'm living my dream. I am. They talk about, you know, enjoy the ride. The journey is what you need to remember. Had a hell of a ride. Hell of a journey. At what cost? Yeah, I know this is going to be a pivotal point in my career as an artist with this album release. Worked very hard. And it's a crucial moment in my career. So this is what I'm trying to portray. Go back to the house. Everybody wants it. They chase after it. What happens when they get there? What is their goal? So this is what I need to ask myself now. As an artist, as an engineer, producer, photographer, videographer, director, the list goes on. I did it. After all these man hours, after all this learning and trials, and what am I going to do with this? What am I going to do with this knowledge? What and how can I apply my skill set moving forward? What do I need?